Whoa!
Wow!
Where am I?
Where the fuck am I?
Everything's so perfect!
So perfect!
No snitches!
Snitches.
Bad bitches!
Ooh,
it's a whole world of freedom!
Really?
Trap bunnies everywhere!
Trap
bunnies! Since the Disney version of this embroidery machine was on sale and therefore cheaper, it came with the Lightning McQueen pattern, and here I have rainbow thread. I would like to make a homosexual Lightning McQueen, please. Oh my goodness. Technology is absolutely incredible. Here's where it might get lost because this is supposed to be a shading layer, but I'm just gonna do more rainbow. The eyes have been embroidered, and unfortunately he is now recognizable. I didn't notice this little squiggle. It embroidered the Disney Pixar trademark! I never knew I had it in me to shitpost with my embroidery machine until now. Ka-chow, homophobes. This is trademarked. It's canon now.
Did you know women's shirts button to the left and men's shirts button to the right? Why? Because our Eurocentric, cis-heteronormative, classist, binary gender system society says that women still can't button their clothes up for themselves, so having the buttons on the left makes it easier for the servants. Meanwhile, men are big boys who can button their own clothes up, so their buttons are on the right, which also assumes that all men and servants are right-handed. It's not a big deal, I'm just salty that the gender binary made extra work for me today, sewing this blue men's shirt and pink women's shirt together to make this adorable fitted two-tone color block button-up shirt, which is low-key a physical metaphorical manifestation of my gender identity. Anyway, no pride for some of us without liberation for all of us. Black trans lives matter.
I've actually got several tips for this, so we're gonna do this in a two-part series. Number one, avoid ace bandages and duct tape. I know there are people that use these methods, but really they can cause way more damage than anything else, especially if you have a larger chest like me, so I would say just to avoid them altogether. Binding tape is a different circumstance if you're doing it properly and you have a smaller chest. Number two, if you're getting a binder online, follow the measurement guide. Every website will show you, based on your measurements, what size you should get, and whatever size it recommends for you is the size you need to get, even if you think it's wrong. As a reference, I wear a size medium shirt, but my binder is a 2XL. If I went too small, I wouldn't be able to get the binder on. If it was too big, it wouldn't do anything. Trust your measurements. Number three, when you get your binder, don't wear it for the whole day the first try. Start with like an hour or two and then gradually work your way up, but listen to your body. If it feels painful, if you feel like you can't breathe, go ahead and take it off, give your body time to settle, and then start again the next day. Stay tuned for part two.
If gay people can call straight people straggots, then why can't we call them the F slur or the D slur? Oh, there's so much to unpack here. Okay, straggit is used to reference straight people who believe themselves to be superior because of their sexuality. The F-slur used to directly reference sticks used to set fires for people who oppose the Catholic Church. It later developed into an insult towards feminine men to give them a bad rep and basically say they should be burned. The D-slur comes from words describing how women should look and act, so any woman who didn't conform to society's expectations would be labeled the D-slur. However, the LGBTQ community has reclaimed both of these words. Isn't straggit just a hypocritical term? I don't use the term because I don't think you can solve one problem by bringing other people down. I think we need to educate and find equality, but if a gay person wants to use the term, then they can. I find it offensive. If you find it offensive, you're probably part of the problem. It's only used to reference homophobic people or comments, so if you're an ally, it won't be used against you, I promise. I'm not homophobic. Sometimes I just like to make fun of the homies and call them gay. Plus, what kind of man would wear makeup? Oh, sweetie, I would never say this, but you're such a straggit.
Happy non-binary day, everyone. I called my parents today to come out to them as non-binary. My mom heard me say, hey, it's non-binary day. I'm calling to let you know that I'm non-binary. And she said, Okay. I don't know how to respond to that. I'm really surprised. Do you want a gift basket or something? And I'm like, that would be great. I mean, if you really want to. Well, guess what? My mom door-dashed me neaters for coming out, and my dad ordered me a new set of dice for my D&D game. If any of y'all want to come out to my parents, I'm willing to set something up for you.
A straight guy, how do you know you're straight? They never have a good answer to that question. Just once, when I ask a straight man, how do you know you're straight? I want a good answer. I want him to just go, well, I blew a guy in a 7-Eleven parking lot. And let me tell you, not for me! 0 out of 5 stars, will not partake in again. Results are conclusive, no need for further evidence. It's the only way you could know. It's the only way you could know.
I don't know what you had in mind, but here we stand on opposing sides. Let's go to war. Let's go to war!
We just moved into a new house, and we got a letter from one of our neighbors, and it's like current resident at our address. And I get it. It's from Jehovah's Witnesses. I'm extremely tempted to have them come over when this is all over. Just, you know, sit them down, entertain them for a little bit, and maybe ask them a few questions. I really hope they like us. Yeah.
Things in my work in progress queer educator classroom that just make sense. Inclusive books that challenge gender stereotypes and the gender binary. Permission to interrupt groups for Megan Rapinoe. Positive affirmations for our inclusive classroom. And a proud declaration.
Dominique, niquez, niquez, s'en allait tout simplement. Routier, pauvre et chantant. En tout chemin, en tout lieu, il ne parle que du bon Dieu. Il ne parle que du bon Dieu. Where is that even from?
5, 6, 7, 8. Dance with me in my backyard, boy.
Gonna hang it?
What?
Where are you gonna hang it?
Off the balcony.
Oh.
So the people that are looking at house next to us know. Plus it's Pride Month.
Because life is short. Life is short and it's fragile. And we don't know how many birthdays we have, so I didn't feel it when the earth. We don't have to have a birthday to celebrate. Really just celebrate life. And you if you haven't told someone you love them, do it now. Do it. Tell people you love them. Call your friends. Text your friends.
You think my kids are confused? All right. Alright, guys.
Yeah?
What am I?
Transgender?
Mm-hmm. Specifically a...
man?
Mm-hmm. But who gave birth to you?
You.
Is that confusing?
No.
Told you.
When I was 18, my friends brought me to a strip club not knowing that I was gay, and they got me a private dance room, and when the stripper came in, I was like, hey, I'm in the closet, and she's like, oh, cool, I'm just doing this to pay for college, and her and I bonded for, like, that entire 45 minutes, and she even ruffled my hair up at the end to make sure it looked real, and honey, I just hope you're doing well. Thanks for being an ally.